Hi Aquarius, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal reading, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Wishing you a very happy birthday, Aquarians. I am wishing you a year of prosperity, of happiness, of lots of peace and lots of joy. I'm also going to be requesting you something which I don't do often, is to please like and subscribe the videos. Do go ahead and share them with your friends. Maybe somebody who's interested in astrology, in tarot, in healing, it could benefit them a lot. So do go ahead and share and subscribe. Be opening the month, Aquarians, with your own house. It's your birthday month, which is brightly lit up. It's all about you, Aquarians. What is it that you want out of life? How is it that you want the world to perceive you? How it is that you see yourself superficially? And there's a lot of harmony that, as well, that you're seeking from externally. You're seeking externally. So it can be that while there is a lot of peace that you're seeking for yourself emotionally as well, you may be trying to, on most days, trying to find that peaceful existence within your head. There are a lot of days when you're seeking that externally as well. There's a lot of external validation that is required for you as far as your work is concerned this month. On the 11th, we have Venus that is moving into your house of money, and this is also the house of your self-worth. And Venus over here is joining Neptune. So it's quite a lovely placement, simply for the fact that it has to do with your money. And I think a lot of Aquarians have been waiting for that good news as far as finances are concerned. And secondly, because it has to do with your self-worth. So it's going to be speaking about your self-esteem, how it is that you feel about yourself. And I think that is far more important than money is. I mean, you can be, you know, you may not have any bank balance, but if you feel like a million buck, I mean, you're sorted. And vice versa, you can have a million buck in your bank, but if you're just feeling horrible all the time, I mean, what use is that money? So with Venus and Neptune over there, it speaks about a soul connect. It speaks about deeply connecting with people. It speaks about also having money, being able to grow that money. It may not have been easy for a lot of you, and I'm sure a lot of you are still on that path of trying to crack your businesses and find that that little break that, okay, it finally, all the pieces sort of fall into place. But with this particular placement, it's almost like a respite. It's almost like, you know, things don't seem as hard as they felt earlier. On the 15th, we have a solar eclipse that is there again in your house of money and self-worth. So again, there's a breakthrough. It can be new opportunity to maybe collaborate, to maybe tie up with someone, which increases in your revenues. On the 18th, we have Mercury that also moves into your house of finance, your earned income, and your house of self-worth. And then on the 19th, we have Sun that is coming and joining Mercury over here. So it's a time, it's a combination of not just having conversations, Aquarians. It's a time of collaboration. It's a time of adapting. It's a time of having courage. That's what Sun, besides shining its entire, in all its glory and giving you its light, it's also asking you to be brave. It's asking you to take hard decisions. And decisions which you may feel really passionately about, you may feel them at a very soul level, but at times it's important to be cutting away from things which are not working, and hence let the rest of the, maybe the business thrive. Maybe you just may have to let go of someone, or maybe you have to cut a certain part of your business which is not doing well, so that the rest of the business doesn't sort of, you know, get drowned along with it. So take those hard calls, as much as it may just bother you. And for those of you in a challenging personal relationships, it's a time to be healing yourself. It's a time to be reaching out, going for therapy, going for counseling, and cutting away, staying away from negative people. If someone's presence, someone's conversations, interactions just pull you down, then you need to be staying away from them, Aquarians. We're closing the month with Mars that is there in your house of groups of people, and it's a brilliant placement because Mars loves action, and this is the house of Being with people who are a part of your tribe, with people who have similar goals, similar aspirations, desires, vision as you do, and you could be meeting with them. Maybe it speaks about attending conferences, being a part of larger network which subscribes to similar kind of work or even personal ethics that you do. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Aquarians. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.